anxiety at the same time. So they have more of this autonomous control attitude for math with lower levels of math anxiety. Whether this is a cause or consequence, it's an interesting question. Definitely, again, there is gender difference in the perception of control for that particular subject. So, what about the potential causes of math anxiety? So we talked about that can be cognitive causes. Perhaps poor math achievement, this can result in some kind of anxiety, but not likely for the majority. Genuinely low memory capacity, perhaps, can result in anxiety if you have this overwhelming feeling of not being able to cope. Emotional, I think that these are the most important ones here. So stereotype threats, road maps, can definitely feel gender differences, control attributions about mathematics. It's important that social acceptability of math, in some countries at least, of weak math, definitely in the United Kingdom is very strong. So it's not really bad to be weak in math. It can even be poor. I'm not sure how about here, probably not. But there, it's perfectly acceptable, maybe especially boys, you know, let's play football, math, who cares about math? No. But there are definitely a lot of social acceptability of weak mathematics. Poor handling of tests or pressure situations in schools, probably, may result in mathematics anxiety. Susceptibility to public embarrassment, for example, if you have to perform in front of a school class, teacher may single you out to demonstrate how stupid you are, this kind of stuff. So it may result in very lasting anxiety. These are all coming from some literature evaluation. And poor reactions to parents or parents to bad marks, for example, this can result in more pressure pulling and transmission of anxiety from parents to teachers. So there are lots of potential causes of anxiety. I think in education settings, it's important to consider all of these and to kind of try to minimize these. Perhaps prevention is the most important. What we know about evaluation, not much. So if you look at therapies, and this is a good summary, this paper, you can try classroom intervention, behavioral therapy, cognitive behavioral therapy. Then some have some effects in the start, but the effect sizes of these are very, very small. So there is no definitive intervention recommended for mathematics anxiety. And I'll jump over this. Some recommended that perhaps expressive writing may be good for handling math anxiety, expressing your own worries about mathematics may be beneficial. The evidence is controversial, depends. Yes, I think, yeah, there's any questions. I think, yeah, sorry, one more. The consequences, because we are on time, so I'm trying not to waste some time. The consequences of math anxiety, those are the really important bits. So on the short term, interferes with successful math solutions, obviously. On the medium term, it obviously avoid elective mathematics classes. And on the long term, the problem is that they may avoid maths-heavy subjects or whole subject areas altogether. And if you think about like gender gap in certain professions, engineering, whatever, then most probably math anxiety is a contributing factor here. Why are girls avoiding certain areas which are non-girly, or they think they are not competent enough? They obviously won't go into those directions. They won't study those subjects. And that's a crucial evil aspect of mathematics anxiety. Now we are doing our large project, which is actually probably the largest study in the UK ever done. Math anxiety, where we do quantitative testing and qualitative interviews with lots of participants. Now we are in the interview phase, so we are supposed to be done with this in about a year's time, when everything should get published. Yeah, I think done. So if you have questions, I tried to force all this material on into these 2 hours. I hope it wasn't too overwhelming.
Staff.
My pleasure.
Thank you. mình đi cách đi cách chỗ đó mà đây cái ông bó ở sân thầy